Now that we have a database, we can take advantage of an Android pattern to bind our view to our data model, known as a content provider. A content provider allows us to think of our view data in terms of URIs, which is a convenient structure for our applications. We can have views display different data based upon which URI is currently active. As it turns out, a URI is the primary data member for those intents that Reto so gloriously described. With a combination of content providers and intents, one can nicely decouple the data being displayed from the view. And there's one other great thing we get from using URI with a data location. It's easy to have our database notify components that are registered to observe that location, which causes our cursor to update our list and show the latest data. Content providers can return all sorts of data, but typically they return either a list of items or a single item. Here's how one might modify our query to select the data for a specific date rather than a range of days, which in this case also contains more information for the viewer to see.